I love flying freestyle, but I don't do enough of it. And part of the problem with that is because I keep flying those rigs. And those rigs are for filming. Each of these Project 399 Super Gs are identical. And the issue with that is that when I fly them for freestyle, I end up breaking more stuff than I usually do for filming. And as a result, when I go to film something, I don't have a working quad, and that's actually really bad form. So I needed some dedicated freestyle rigs. Recently, I was down in Texas hanging out with Catalyst Machine Works, and we got to talking, like, why don't we make kind of like a signature bind and fly FPV freestyle drone and, you know, make it available for people to purchase, but then also, Paul, you can fly it and break it and not have to worry about needing it for filming when you're breaking all of your other stuff. So we got together and we came up with this. This is Catalyst Machine Works Banggod. It's this insanely durable, high quality carbon fiber frame, and we put a little awesome print pattern on it, and it looks phenomenal. But it's got bumpers on the front and back, so like you're almost never gonna break the arm. You've got this massive GoPro mount that is gonna protect it from smashing. Like, there's no way you're gonna break that back screen and the front screen. I don't know if you can see, but it's that front screen is super indented in there, so it's really, there's a lot of protection against hurting that. Plus, it works with the TBS like slide-in ND filters and all that stuff. So you can buy this rig exactly as it is with my tune, with my rates, and have it all yours. So that's the goal, is that I have something that I can fly, and then Catalyst can also, you know, sell the bind and fly version. We're using these Brother Hobby Avenger V2. Actually, you know what? Let's rewind, go back to when I first unboxed it, so you can check it out for the first time. All right, we got something new here. This is a package from Catalyst Machine Works. Really excited about what's in here. We've been working together to develop a signature series FPV freestyle ready to fly drone, and I'm seeing it for the first time today. Oh, it's beautiful. Look at that bad boy. All right, so this is the Catalyst Machine Works Banggod. This is the name of their frame series. You've got an adjustable camera tilt here up front for the GoPro, well, obviously, and the DJI air unit. I'm probably gonna lower it because I like my camera tilt a little bit lower. Big ol' super protective. This is a GoPro 8 mount. They obviously make a 9 as well. Pretty much gonna lock one of my 8s into this. XT60 pass-through with a capacitor, battery strap, everything's nice and contained up top in the drone. Right now we're running a Brother Hobby Avenger V2. These are the 1850 KV versions. Super tough, strong motor. Absolutely in love with them. You got the DJI antennas mounted. You got a crossfire mounted. We went with the T-Motor ESC because they're easier to find right now than the Hobbywing. The Hobbywing is still my favorite, but these are really, really good as well. Combined with a Holy Bro Kakute F7 flight controller. It has a pass-through for the DJI air unit, so it plugs in nice and clean. Like, if you can look in that build, it's just so clean in there because there's just no wiring that has to be done. So it's gonna hold up over time. You're not gonna have any connections go loose. It's just beautiful. We got this awesome custom skin. We're gonna be working on like a NURK version of this skin, but this was my favorite out of the ones that were available right now. Kind of got this like hexagon pattern. Looks super cool. I cannot wait to fly this thing. I've seen testing videos of this, and it looks like it flies amazing with that F7 with these chonky motors and the Gem Van Hurricane props. You guys can run whatever props you want. I'm probably gonna use the Azure Power Vanover Edition props. Those are some of my favorites right now. But yeah, let's get this thing set up and ready to roll. So the first time you insert the GoPro, you want to run a heat gun on the mount to kind of loosen it up, and then you're going to fit it in, and then every time after that it's going to be perfectly fit. So we just got to kind of gently warm this whole thing up. And now we take the GoPro in. Wedge her on in there, and then we're going to let that cool for a sec, and essentially the GoPro mount is going to set. So while that's cooling, we'll leave the GoPro in there, get the everything bound up, and then we'll be ready to rock. Oh yeah, she's ready to rip.
All right, this is the first flight on the Catalyst Machine Works Banggod NURK edition. Let's get it.
flew amazing. Out of the box, my tune, my rates, that was all I changed. It was so smooth flying in the hand. I actually don't fly a lot of drones. For the most part, I'm flying them off the DJI controller, but this drone is running on Crossfire, so you've got that super long range slash mid range availability. You can fly this up a mountain just fine and use it for long range freestyle, short range freestyle, all that good stuff. And that was why I made sure that we ran it off of the Crossfire instead of the DJI air unit. Now, that being said, you can order it whichever way you want, whether that's with a Crossfire antenna or with the DJI full system or potentially even an analog version. I don't know who's flying analog anymore, but you know, that's where it's at. But flying it just around the yard, chasing the dogs around, like I was sending it up over the tree and like barely hitting the ground. I'm like, oh, there's so much resolution in the control. It is a little bit heavier. It's definitely a freestyle rig because of like, you know, massive GoPro thing and super durable frame. But what that meant is that my throttle control was much more linear, so even at the bottom, I could kind of like just give it a little bit extra and it would just sit down on the ground and then it was awesome. I can't wait to go fly it again. So I'm headed out tomorrow morning to like Western Massachusetts. My wife and I are going on a little bit of a baby moon, but as part of the hiking, because she's, you know, pregnant, she wants to stop every once in a while to hike. So she's like, why don't you bring some drones? And I'm like, well, why don't I bring this drone? So we're headed out first thing in the morning to Massachusetts, bring you guys along for a little bit of that ride, traveling in the time of pandemic. And then we'll get some flying in on this and you can see how awesome it is for freestyle. Thanks very much. See you tomorrow.
This flies awesome. And we're out here. Rachel and I are now out in Western Massachusetts, opposite of where Boston is. And it's a beautiful, beautiful weather, beautiful time to be flying. Got my Aurora heated vest on. It's not on though, it's not that cold. But there's this beautiful bridge right here that we're gonna fly on whilst there is good sun. I think it should be really fun. Also, beautiful, beautiful river. Look at all that. I think it's gonna be a good spot. Let's do it. We'll be right back. This thing's flying amazing. Easy peasy, let's go find a new spot while we still got sun.
One thing that I wanted to hone in on was that with the combination of these gigantic motors, which have the ability to just crunch through any prop or battery combination, is that because of the extra weight, this being a freestyle drone, of course, any varying weather conditions is going to make it still fly smooth. So in this flight, I want you to notice how much the trees are being blown around at the top of the canopy, and notice that the drone is not affected by it at all, giving you super smooth, beautiful flight, even when it's terrible, terrible wind conditions. I'm not gonna say it was the weight of the drone that saved me there, or pilot error or anything, but yeah, that was hairy. One of the things that I'm loving the most about this drone is not just that it does a great job of freestyle and it's durable, but then I can kind of take it back off, get these nice kind of cinematic slow style movements, and then dive right back into the canopy and go ham. You can kind of do both. I've actually used this for some production shoots now, as well as just flying around for freestyle and getting some of that sick ribbage, you know. So after a successful trip out to Boston to capture a bunch of freestyle and do some cinematic flying and all that good fun stuff, Rachel and I finished up our little baby moon and headed back to Indianapolis, and it was time to do some durability testing with good old Winston.
I just had a bit of a big smash, hit a metal pole, well, maybe metal, not sure. I'm pretty sure the drone's fine, but we're about to find out. I don't think that was me, but I'm gonna claim it was. So, I took a little bit of a dent there, but I mean, I smacked it. Maybe that was me. But yeah, she's good to go. GoPro's fine, battery's fine, some bent props, but that's all. Big hit. I hit another metal pole. I was trying to do a power loop and go through the handrail in the middle of the power loop.
Oh.
Looks good. I hit it dead on. And the prop just got loose. She's good. Get it, you vape. All right, so Winston is gonna try out the Banggod for the first time. He's not flown this, I've flown it quite a bit, but I wanna just get his reaction because I think you guys trust his reaction, I trust his reaction, and we'll see what it's like flying the Banggod for the first time here. Actually, this is a pretty great spot.
It is a really cool spot.
All right, let's get him in the air.
Ready?
Yeah.
Holy no camera angle, Batman.
It's low. It's freestyle. What do you think?
Man, who tuned this thing? I'm kidding. Nah, this thing's probably pretty good. Those motors are definitely nice and down.
I didn't want pretty good. I wanted, this is amazing.
I was waiting for the audio. All right, cool. We're good now. You on me?
No.
Man, this is pretty good. I can't lie.
Ooh.
Ah! Dude, this thing's got some juice.
2507 chuchers.
For real. Yeah, this thing's pretty nice. It's got a little bit more weight, but it ain't bad at all. You can really throw it around.
Winston doesn't really do freestyle rigs. He doesn't know that they're supposed to be heavy.
No, I know they
That's
are.
How you get the juice.
No, I know they are, which this is nice. Now, the other builds I've been flying lately are a little bit on the lighter side. That's why I was more noticeable than normal. Oh!
What just happened?
I had to branch. DJI!
It doesn't sound great, but it looks fine.
Oh no.
It's fine. You won't get, like, there's so much displacement on those motors.
Yeah, I don't want to burn up your bearings. I like it, man. That's a pretty good build. Seems. I've seen your record, so I know it's durable, that's for sure, but it definitely flies nice. I'm gonna have to build me one of those things.
You can also, if you don't want to build it, it's available as a bind and fly from Catalyst F Machine Works.
Yeah, overall, definitely a nice freestyle quad. The thing looked durable from what Paul did to it earlier, and it flies great. It's got juice, man. That thing goes. I'm kind of surprised, honestly. I'm gonna have to get some 2507s at the least.
Try absolutely blown away. That's more like it.
It's fucking fast, man! It's fast!
We don't swear on this channel.
No, that's good, man. I enjoy it. That was good. Good job, guys.
So to give just a final summary on the bird, it's amazing. The extra weight makes it perfect for freestyle. Those 2507 motors just power through everything. I really, really like big, heavy motors. I've been falling in love with them ever since I built like that 12S drone a few months back, and it's awesome. Combining that with the quality of the Hero 8, the amazing build work done at Catalyst Machine Works, all this good stuff. Like, I've had a chance to take it on to set with me a couple times. It's made me some money now, all that good stuff, and it's all because of this drone. My goal when I set out at the beginning of this entire ordeal was to have a drone that I can just grab and go. It's ready at any time, and I can just get out and go flying. I'm not fiddling around. I'm not doing anything. I'm not strapping stuff down, and that's what it's been. The GoPro Hero 8 has just lived in that awesome protective case. I've got a battery near it ready to go, and I just grab my stuff and I can get out and fly. And that's kind of the door that it's been unlocking for me, and that's why I'm really in love with it. So if you're interested in buying one of these, they're available at Catalyst Machine Works right now. I'm not like forcing anyone to go buy them. I'm not saying that this is the best thing out there. It's perfect for me, for what I want to do. And if you want to, you know, have that same experience, that's what I would recommend for you to jump in on. So please feel free to go check it out. Any support that you give that machine, it supports Catalyst, who's doing awesome work in the cinema and the freestyle markets, and then it supports me to continue making awesome content like this. So thank you very much for hanging out today, and stay flying.